While there are a lot of minerals out there, we humans tend to have some favorites, and those tend to fall into two basic categories. There are the pretty ones that sparkle or glow, and there are the useful ones, which, thanks to some specific property of the material, we can use to make our lives easier. But there's a rare few, like this pretty blue rock, that have a foot in both camps. This is sodalite, and it's found everywhere from the halls of a British royal's mansion to chemical processing plants. And it could even be the key to cleaning up some of our pollution messes, meaning it could make our world prettier too. In 1901, the Princess of Wales, who would later become Queen Mary, wife of King George V of England, was given a piece of sodalite from a quarry in Ontario. It was a colorful mass of small royal blue crystals with white streaks running through it. The princess was so taken with the stone that she immediately ordered some in bulk to decorate her palatial home, Marlborough House, in London. The owners named their quarry the Princess Sodalite Quarry in honor of, or maybe just to simply cash in on, the royals' interest. And while sodalite is valuable as an ornamental stone, it isn't actually all that rare. It's a silicate mineral related to quartz and feldspar, but it also contains sodium within its structure, hence the name, sodium, sodalite. You get it. Sodalite forms in a wide range of igneous and metamorphic settings, typically when there isn't too much silica around. Mostly it's found as colorful polycrystalline masses like the ones from the Princess Sodalite Quarry, but occasionally you can find individual crystals too. There are some clear or whitish crystals found near Mount Vesuvius in Italy. And one rare form of sodalite called hackmanite can even change color when it's exposed to certain kinds of UV light. It shifts from pink to purple in the sun, like those super cool sneakers that I always wanted as a kid, and my mom said no. So sodalite can be pretty in all kinds of ways, but it also has a lot more going on than just looks, because it's also a zeolite. Zeolites are crystalline silicate minerals that have these really tiny pores in them, like the size of individual molecules tiny. They're named after the Greek word for boiling stone, because water molecules can sit in those pores and be released when the mineral is heated up, making it look like the rock itself is, well, boiling. But the size and arrangement of pores in zeolites also means that they can act like nanoscopic sieves made to filter out specific molecules, which is where they get their other creative name of molecular sieves. And sodalite's crystal structure makes it the ideal basis for a zeolite. On the atomic scale, this is how it's built. First, you've got aluminum and silicon atoms that are each bonded to four oxygen atoms, making tetrahedra shaped like triangle-based pyramids. These tetrahedra are then linked to one another by their corner oxygens, creating a 3D cage-like structure out of pyramids, all joined together at their tips. The shape of that cage is like an octahedron with all of its points shaved off, leaving it with eight hexagonal faces and six square faces, looking kind of like a soccer ball. These crystal cages have open spaces inside and between them, where so-called guest atoms can hang out. This is what creates the zeolite pores. Sodalite signature cages are also found in plenty of other natural and artificial zeolites. And yes, zeolites can be DIY'd in a lab. In fact, these days, the majority of zeolites are man-made, since chemists can design different arrangements of cages to create the perfect pore size for the job at hand. Sodalite cages are among the smallest you can get, at roughly 2.5 angstroms across, which is about twice the width of a hydrogen atom. And depending on how those cages stack together, you can get pores up to 10 or more angstroms in diameter. The fact that their structures can be so easily manipulated, as well as the fact that the pores are about the same size of atoms and molecules, means that zeolites with sodalite cages have become really valuable to industrial chemistry. They're used as ion exchangers in things like water softeners and laundry detergents, trapping calcium and magnesium inside the pores and preventing them from precipitating out as limescale. You can also use them as catalysts to speed up chemical reactions, like converting ethanol into gasoline. The right size of pore can trap a chosen molecule and hold it in place space while chemical reactions happen to it. Like how cutting a dog's nails is easier if there's a second person there to hold them still. Same goes for cats. It is very hard to clip a cat's nails. And speaking of cats, your cat probably spends a lot of time around zeolites too, since they're great at absorbing liquids and thus are a common ingredient in kitty litter. And zeolites are also playing an important role in reducing the human impact on the environment. For instance, some zeolites have been created to selectively absorb methane from mining emissions. Methane is a particularly potent greenhouse gas, so by removing it, we can help to limit the amount of global warming the planet experiences. Zeolites might also be key to making better energy storage solutions. They're great at holding on to notoriously lightweight hydrogen atoms, which stops them escaping from clean hydrogen fuel cells. And they're being put to use to support another carbon neutral power source, helping to process radioactive nuclear waste. In nuclear power plants, spent nuclear fuel can be stored short term in storage ponds, which is mostly fine, but some of the fission products are soluble, and if you're not careful, that contamination can leach out over time. But when zeolites are added into the ponds, the pores trap the fission products, and the powdered material can be pressed into a solid block, sealing off the pores and reducing the radioactive hazard. Not only that, but in the case of rare but devastating nuclear accidents, zeolites can help with cleanup efforts. Like when zeolites were added into contaminated water and soils after Chernobyl and Fukushima, they reduced the concentration of radioactive nuclides by up to 1,000 times. It's not often you get a gemstone that is both easy on the eye and the basis for so much of modern and future industry, but sodalite is one such mineral hero. And Roxbox subscribers can look forward to receiving their own piece of industrial beauty, though these pieces are probably going to look better on your bookshelf than in your litter box. Roxbox subscribers get a sample of every month's mineral sent right to their door. Whether you want to sign up or just check out some of our other mineral merch, you can head over to scishow.rocks to learn more.